Welcome back to the channel, guys. And in today's video, we are going to feature Typhlosion in Ultra League Remix. And the Typhlosion, in my opinion, is a very good Pokemon. And if you manage to get ahead on energy with it, then it pretty much can ruin your opponent's backline. And I was able to get in a lot of good matches with it. And in today's video, I'm going to feature a 5-0 set which I used with the team. And as of now, as well, I'm using Typhlosion in my battles. And I probably will feature that team in tomorrow's video though, but for now it's a 5-0 set, and along with that a bonus battle towards the end, which was like super close. And before we start with the battles, if you are new to the channel and if you like our content, don't forget to hit the like and subscribe button. If you're already subscribed to the channel, a big thanks to all of you. And if you want to join the battles at Discord server, the link to that is in the description down below. So without further delays, let's start with the battles and see how the battle goes. So we are in a Berserker lead, and this lead is typically strong for Snorlax. And as I mentioned in my previous video as well, I really like Snorlax leads because it does manage to catch hold of a lot of common leads, and close combat from Berserker does not KO. So this is still okay with me. And they throw their energy. This is most likely going to be a foul play, or they go for a double close combat. That's quite surprising. But now that they have lowered their defense by 4 stages, we can body slam. And take a lot of health. And in comes Drifblim. So this team with a shield advantage and switch advantage is really really dominating. So I would stay in this matchup because Drifblim cannot farm us down really, and we can just spam those body slams. They would need to throw Icy Wind at this range, and I want to chunk away as much energy as I can of this Drifblim so that I can come in with Typhlosion and look to farm down a lot of energy. And since we are running Toxicroak in the back, it will do really good up against that Berserker. Toxicroak resists everything that thing can throw. So farming bunch of extra energy, and I didn't shield the Shadow Ball. That was probably the incorrect play, but because now I would have to shield this Icy Wind. So let's see what the opponent has in the back. If they have something like Politoed in the back, it's going to be very bad because we are out of shields at this moment. So they end up having Machamp in the back, so this is quite good because Toxicroak walls both Berserker and Machamp, and we are already loaded up on 2 Blast Burns. So all I need to do is I need to take them out and grab the shield with Toxicroak if possible. So that's why I go straight Sludge Bomb, because that will either take the shield or will do a lot of damage. It does a lot of damage, and Machamp will need to throw their energy in order to take us out. And since Typhlosion is low enough, I didn't want to risk getting hit with counter, so hence I throw the energy immediately. Maybe that could have been the incorrect decision, but this is what I wanted to go for since we are running Incinerate, and it's a Shadow Machamp, so counter will do a lot of damage. I think that was probably the right play. There was no way I could have allowed a counter to enter in between. So yeah, GG's. Moving on to the next one, picking up a positive lead in the form of the Giratina. And Giratina does run Shadow Ball and Dragon Pulse, so all they can do is throw Dragon Pulse at us, which will not KO. So I make a mistake here, and as you can see, Typhlosion with energy is quite deadly because I allow Typhlosion to get ahead on energy, and this will allow Typhlosion to get to another Blast Burn, and I will need to shield this if I want to keep that matchup of Snorlax intact. So yeah, that Typhlosion made me spend 2 shields, and that was probably the result of my incorrect play. But still, this just shows how crazy strong Typhlosion is. So they will be able to get to this Shadow Ball, and Shadow Ball I think will be able to knock us out. So undoubtedly we are coming in with the Snorlax, and if they have a Politoed in the back, this is going to be like GG's for me. So they are staying in this matchup surprisingly. Maybe they are not running. Maybe they have something weak to Snorlax in the back. Maybe another Ghost type. So I didn't really see what they came in with, but they came in with Torterra, so this is quite good. And I mean, this is probably the best situation that we could have been in this particular game. So I know Torterra has access to Stone Edge or Sand Tomb, so that's why I throw just to grab that shield, because getting the shield is really critical at this stage. So if it's a sand tomb, it will not KO, but stone age definitely will. So it ends up being a stone age with, yeah, with just one shots the Typhlosion at that range. So but yeah, the Snorlax is too way too healthy to beg to get KO'd with the Giratina. Even with the Dragon Pulse, we knock out by throwing the lick. So yeah, good game. Moving on to the next one, we are in an Excadrill lead, so let's see how we like to play. So in this map, particular matchup, I like to take a drill run to the face, and then if the opponent decides to shield the charge move, I end up investing a shield myself. But if not, then I let go of Snorlax and come in with Typhlosion to farm. So this will allow us to shield the drill run and get to the next charge move, and hence I go for the shield, because either we will grab both the shields or we will knock out the Excadrill to win this matchup. And as you can see, I got too greedy there, which forced me to apply another shield, which is not quite good. I did not want to do that, honestly, but then ended up double shielding the Excadrill, which I was not expecting, to be honest. And they come in with Shadow Guard, so Gardevoir will take a lot of time to get to a charge move, and I knew that Excadrill has some residual energy on their side, so I farmed a bunch of extra energy so that they'll be pressured to throw. And since their Charmer is out of the picture, maybe the backline Toxicroak will be able to handle. So I wait out the Switch Clock definitely, and now I would come in with Toxicroak. So Toxicroak knocks out the Excadrill, and they have a Roserade in the back. So the game is pretty much wrapped up, because Sludge Bomb will almost be able to knock out the Roserade, and yeah, Leaf Storm is the hardest hitting move of Roserade, which is resisted by Toxicroak. So yeah, the game is pretty much wrapped up at this particular stage, and I did not want to take any risk, so hence I go for Body Slam, but the game is far far from over when that Roserade came in. So yeah, good game. Moving on to the next one, let's see, and we are in a Magnezone matchup. So this matchup is neutral. I mean, Magnezone need to land one wild charge and a mirror shot if it want to take us out, and Snorlax can just simply go for Snorlax need to land a superpower. And here I made a mistake. Probably I got nervous and threw the superpower early, but I really could have saved that energy. But the opponent ended up shielding anyway, so yeah, it didn't really matter. So in comes opposing Snorlax, and they are loaded on energy that I need to make sure. So I throw this Body Slam, and they ended up double shielding, which was quite surprising to me, because giving up two shields at this stage is not a very good play. But I'm not sure what was going in their head. So this Sludge Bomb will be able to knock them out. Maybe they wanted to draw a fighter out because they have a Gallade in the back. But yeah, this will show real power of Typhlosion, because I shield this charge move, because even though it's a Leaf Blade, the confusion damage will really hurt Typhlosion. So, and I wanted to farm a lot of energy, because I know that there is a Magnezone in the back with potentially loaded energy. So I knock out the Gallade after throwing after knowing that I will be one incinerate away from the charge move. So incinerate will be knocking out the will frying that steel type. So yeah, good game. Moving on to the next one, and we are in an Alolan Ninetales lead. So let's see if it's a charm or a powder snow. So it's a charm version, so this is slightly better for Snorlax, because or they swap out to Drifblim. I'm not sure why they did that, but Snorlax with loaded energy can win against Drifblim even with the debuff. So this is like probably better for me, because now that I know that they are running charm, I will be able to pair Typhlosion up against that Ninetales. So they go for an Icy Wind, and I think Snorlax, even in an even energy scenario, wins. Shadow Snorlax, even in an even energy scenario, win against Drifblim. So yeah, this is a favorable matchup for Snorlax regardless. So yeah, I'm not shielding this charge move, because this will not KO, and yeah, Drifblim, can it farm us down at that range? Yeah, I think the opponent got greedy. I think they tried to go for they tried to farm us down, which allowed us to get to a body slam. This will knock out their Drifblim, and they come in with Ninetales, which is fine with me because I have a very strong answer to that. And they have a Jellicent in the back, so this is not looking quite good because I really need to start taking those shields or land a Solar Beam, and they debuff us with a Bubble Beam as well. And since they debuffed us, I straight went for Solar Beam because the opponent might not shield up as they do. So this is probably good for us now. This matchup is quite over, and I'd throw the Solar Beam straight away because Solar Beam does not give after getting debuffed, and the opponent might be knowing that. So that was the reason that I did not that I went straight Solar Beam. So the opponent is throwing Bubble Beams, like they're going straight Bubble Beams, but this allowed us to get a lot of energy in return. So we go for the Mudbomb bait. I'm not sure whether it's a good bait or not, but ends up being good. But that was quite risky, especially since Toxic Rogue was twice debuffed. So now we go for the Sludge Bomb, and this does not take them out, but it will put them low enough, and our Switch Timer is up. And with two shields, I think Typhlosion can just incinerate down and melt this fairy and ice type Ninetales. So yeah, Weather Balls, I ended up shielding because eventually I would need to, and I don't want to risk just for a two shield flex, especially since they are running charm and then they quit, yeah, realizing they cannot win. So yeah, GG's. Moving on to the next one, and we are in a Tentacruel lead. So I didn't really know how this matchup goes, and they're running Poison Jab as well. It knows Poison Jab, or is it Poison Sting? I think it's Poison Jab. So this is just an acid spray. It's too soon to be in Hydro. So they go for an acid spray, and I definitely should only go for Body Slam. Superpower is resisted because of Tentacruel's poison typing. So we go for this. We go for back-to-back body slam. Oh, we go for back-to-back body slams, and I want to get the Tentacruel low enough so that Typhlosion can farm. And now that they have shielded, I'm very much committed to letting go of Snorlax, because as I said, Typhlosion with energy advantage can really do a lot of damage, and in comes Scrafty. So this is probably the best situation that we could have been in because Scrafty is getting balled by our Toxicroak, and even though they will raise their defense, and now the foul play might do a lot of damage, and that this is the reason that I go for a charge move. So not expecting them to shield, which they obviously do not, and now they will be able to get to a foul play. So yeah, maybe throwing energy was not quite a good decision, but regardless, we are able to counter down the Scrafty. So in comes the Giratina. I think I saw Shadowclaws. Yeah, so in comes their Giratina, which will be able to farm us down. But we are at a two shield advantage, and we have a Typhlosion, like quite healthy Typhlosion in the back. So the game is still not over, to be honest, because Giratina can really hurt. But the two shield advantage really helps. And it's not two shield, it's three shield. So Snorlax rescuing us in a three shield, and they go for an ominous wind, which will allow them to farm us down. Unfortunately, we are not able to throw a body slam. So this can be a Dragon Pulse, but ended up being a bait. So I really don't like to be in this situation. So I go for a straight Blast Burn because I didn't want Tentacruel to lower our defense with the acid spray, but actually they end up doing that, and I don't want to shield because acid spray does not do a lot of damage, and two, if I did that, the ominous wind will just knock us out. So I throw one incinerate away, like just shy of 100 energy. This will grab the shield, and this is going to be clutch because we are debuffed, and the Shadow Claws will do a lot of damage. So we are barely able to make it to the Blast Burn, and this Blast Burn will definitely be able to knock out the Giratina. So that was very, very close, and yeah, that just shows the power of Typhlosion. So yeah, good game. So that's it for this video, guys. I really hope you enjoyed watching this one as much as I enjoyed playing with this team. So that's it for this video, guys. Until next time, peace.